am Corvette Hop, and first of all, thank you for watching. We all know this channel would not be possible if it wasn't for each and every one of you. Today we're going to do something special for this 2017 Grand Sport. I'll let John go ahead and explain.
What we're going to be doing is we're going to be removing the center console in order to take it apart and hydro dip it and help it look an improvement on Corvette's original design.
There you go, John. And with that, we're going to make this console go from this to this. And I hope you enjoy the video.
Make sure the car is on a level surface and you have wheel chocks to prevent the car from rolling. Next, go ahead and put the car in neutral so we'll be able to put the upper console over the shifter. Now go ahead and shut the car off as it is in neutral. If the car is a standard, put it in fourth gear. Next, go ahead and disconnect the battery. The battery is located in the trunk of the C7 Corvette on the passenger side. Go ahead and use a 10mm socket to remove the battery terminal. Once removed, tuck it away so there's no possibility of touching the battery terminal. Now let's start removing the upper center console. In order to do that, we need to remove the armrest. Let's start by removing three screws. You can do this by using a T15 Torx. Once all three torque screws are removed, go ahead and push outward to remove the armrest. Let's now remove some of the trim off of the upper console. Notice the special tool that we're using from Harbor Freight to keep from anything from getting scratched up. Simply just pry the trim loose until it comes off.
When you've got them all out, pull it backward because there's a small tab here that if you pry it straight out, you'll break it. And when you put it back in, return it the same way, starting with this tab in the slot first, and then pressing in, moving back toward the back.
Now let's go ahead and remove the small cover forward the console. Simply just snap it out. Use your tool to lift up on the console. Go ahead and work your way around the console to completely make it loose from the tabs. Once the center upper console is loose from the bottom tabs, go ahead and lift up and then pull backwards to remove it from the forward portion of the console. Now you'll be able to get at the connectors on the underside of the console. The first connector we'll remove goes to the drive control. Just push in on the tabs and pull it out. Now let me show you that again with a better view. The second connector goes to the emergency brake. Simply just push in on the tabs on the side and pull it out. And here is a bottom view of removing this same connector. Next, we're going to go ahead and disconnect the shifter boot from the console. Now, this can be a little tricky. The best way is to lift up on the little tabs on the underside and then push it through. Now, feeding the shifter boot through was no easy task, just keep working it. The easiest way for me was to lift up, push the top portion under, and then feed it through. The shifter indicator connector does not have to be removed because you're pushing the boot through the console anyway. Once you get the shifter boot through the center console, you can then flip the console over and remove the cigarette lighter connector. This is a close-up view of the cigarette lighter connector. Just push on the prongs right here and pull it out. Now you can remove the upper half of the center console. This next part is for those Corvettes with convertible tops only. You will need to remove the cover between the seats. Remove two screws that require a Torx 25. Make sure the convertible top is up partially so you can remove the two plugs behind the cover. Go ahead and completely remove both of the panel plugs. Once both plugs have been removed, you can now lift up on the cover to remove it.
You got anything else going on?
Now we can go ahead and remove the cover that was under the armrest. This will allow us to get at 2 10-millimeter nuts that need to be removed. Go ahead and use a 10-millimeter deep socket. This is what the center lower console looks like with the cover and the two nuts removed. Now we'll go ahead and identify four additional nuts that need to be removed. It's number one and number two. And then forward the lower control panel, three, and then number four. You guessed it, 10-millimeter socket is required. Now you may note that the dash is removed in this car. That is for a different project and no need to worry. However, you may note that John has put painter's tape over the nav screen to protect it from any scratches. And now the last nut, then we start removing some wire connectors. First, let's go ahead and remove the forward connector.
Okay. Tab. Push down and pull.
I'm going to go ahead and release the second half of the wire connector from the lower console simply by lifting up under it. The second wire connector on the lower console was loaded right here in this location. Simply push in on the tab and pull out to release it. The third and last wire connector is loaded right here in this location. The first thing I'm going to do is release the wire connector from the lower console so that I can easily get at the connector. And now that I can easily get to the wire connector, just simply push in on the tab and release it. One additional note, John is showing how the wires go through the channel on the lower console. Make sure it goes that way when you reinstall. Now you can simply pull back on the lower console, feed the wires through the console to the bottom, along with the shifter plate. Make sure no wires get caught up on the lower console, simply lift up and pull out. This is what the upper and lower center console look like removed. Now it goes to Mile to Wild in Converse, Texas to get hydro dipped. When you're ready, reinstall in reverse order. Now, Miles Wild address is 8373 Brooks Drive, Converse, Texas, 78109. Their phone number is 210-661-0825. The nice thing about hydro dipping is you can get it in any color, any design to match your interior or exterior of your car. Mile to Wild knows how to do it right. Let's go ahead and take a quick look at John's 2017 Grand Sport.
With that, we hope you learned something. If you really like what you see, go ahead and subscribe to the channel right here. With that, go ahead, John.
Keep those cars on the road.
Thank you for watching.